Hey everyone and welcome to this guide. If you're looking at this right now, you may probably want to learn more about Riven. You are on the right video. First of all, know that Riven has many different combos, but it is important to only learn the most efficient ones first and slowly practice them. In this video, we are going to talk about her kits and her combos. If you want to learn about anything that is not related to that or even learn more about the fast Q combo, I invite you to check my previous videos. The links are in the description. Let's talk about one of the most used combo on Riven, the double cast. After using her E, Riven has a small delay in which she can execute what is called the double cast, meaning that she can use two spells at the same time. The thing is that there is a specific delay, she cannot do it instantly after using E, as she needs to wait almost half a second first. But if she waits too much, she won't be able to execute it either. This clip is the preview of a simple double cast. You have enough time to add a basic attack between the usage of E and W. If you are playing with Electrocute, then this combo will instantly proc it. You can also use your Tiamat or Ravenous Hydra before using a double cast. We are going to reproduce the same combo we just did, but add the Tiamat before the double cast. You can also flash before using your double cast. Do not forget to buffer your auto attack by right-clicking on a target before flashing in for faster DPS. You can still make use of Tiamat or Hydra in combo as well. Keep in mind that you can still use a Tiamat before a double cast, no matter the circumstance. If you are able to double cast, then you should be able to auto attack and use Tiamat before, as long as you respect the timing of course. You can hide the animation of your ultimate, this will allow you to use it while going forward. This way, you will be able to keep chasing people without having to stop running. A key thing about Riven is that you can mix different combos together in order to make one. So now that we learned the E double cast and the ER combo, we are going to make use of both in a single footage. After using E, you have enough delay to use both ultimate and auto attack before making use of your double cast. Do not forget that you can still use your Tiamat before using a double cast. It is possible to buffer the second activation of your ultimate and your Q spell. If you are close enough, your Q spell should hit first, which will increase the damage of your Wind Slash as it is an execute. As we saw earlier, you have to mix different combos together in order to pull things off with Riven. So, let's now mix the three combos we learned earlier, ER, double cast and R2Q. You still can use Flash and Tiamat Hydra. This combo is only a mashup of the previous combos we learned earlier. Do not forget that you can use Tiamat before the WQ double cast and that you can also flash right after your ER combo. You can also use your Tiamat while dashing by using E followed by Tiamat. You can also use those items before using Flash and the damage will still be dealt at the end of the Flash. With what we just learned, we can create a combo that can finish a low health target in a fast timing. Your Tiamat and Q will deal the damage before your ult reaches the target. Using Tiamat before flashing will also surprise them more than if you use it after, as they could react faster otherwise. You can hide a part of the ult animation by using Tiamat before. It's even better if your Tiamat hits the target as it will increase your ultimate's damage. Here we are, the most meme combo on the Riven main subreddit, the Shy combo. This one was discovered by The Shy, a Korean Riven player. Its goal is to 100 someone with the least amount of time possible for them to react. You can flash while casting the second activation of your ultimate. This way, your target will have to react faster than if you flashed before throwing your ult, as it will reach them faster. You can also use it while dashing forward with your E by pressing E followed by R. We are now going to mix this combo with a double cast one. This may mostly be useful when a lot of enemies midlife are packed together. You can also use your R and Q as a double cast combo. It helps you to reach your target easier and you will eventually deal more damage to the target as your ultimate increases its hitbox. As usual, you can also auto-attack between E and the double cast combo, as well as using Tiamat. Riven is allowed to use her stun while dashing for E, but the stun location will depend on how fast she pressed her WK. There's a trick allowing Riven to wind slash backward as she dashes forward. It's not done that often, but it's sometimes useful in order to live and get a kill without taking any risk. Or, you know, if you just want to get some stat points. Thing is, your wind slash will always go toward the position where your cursor was when you pressed R. So if you dash past the cursor, you will go forward, but your wind slash will still go in the direction you ordered it to go with the cursor. Riven has great tools to engage fights if her opponent makes a positioning mistake. Flashing onto them or jumping over a wall, she can definitely turn the game around with a powerful engage. The following clip is one of the most basic combo to engage as Riven. Extend your Q by waiting the last moment before using the next one, then dash forward with your E, and then flash in followed by a third Q. Do not third Q before flashing. Flashing during the Q animation will cancel it, so there will be no damage and no knockup. You don't especially have to wind slash when flashing if it's not necessary. Keep in mind that it does more damage to the lowest HP targets. The next combo is a pretty insane one as the damage input can be very high and go very fast. Boxbox uses it a lot when it comes to contesting Nashor, and his opponents are not totally full health due to the damage taken from the Baron. You want to use your Wind Slash before using your E to go forward and flash double cast into the enemy team. If you respect this timing, your Wind Slash will begin at the very first position, far behind your flash and E location. This will give enough time for your double cast to hit before your Wind Slash reaches. Therefore, the burst damage will be insane. We are now gonna talk about the last combo of this video. When using your ultimate, no matter if it is the first or second activation, you can input buffer your W. They will both go off almost instantly. If using the first activation of your ult, you will turn it on while stunning the people around you. If you do this combo while casting your windslash, then the stun will go off and deal the damage before the projectile reaches the target, increasing its execute damage. It also works with your flash. You can use the wind slash flash combo that we saw earlier, but on top of that, you will use your W right after flashing. It seems like we are done with this guide, but more are to come. Before ending the video, I'm gonna share with you a few tips that most people don't know about Riven. After that, I will share with you a few streamers that you could watch if you wanna get better at a champ. When Riven's ultimate is active, her basic attack, Q spells and W ranges are increased as well as her AD. This is why she can hit people with her Qs and stun from way further than usual. The fact that her ultimate also increases her AD makes her damage insane as long as it is active. Riven's W and Q animations can be cancelled by right-clicking on the ground with a move command, which can help her making faster combos and increase her DPS, leaving less reaction time for her opponent. Riven's Q is an auto-attack reset. This is why being able to cancel its animation perfectly in the fast Q combo can totally change the result of a trade as it will increase her DPS. As for the streamers, the first one I recommend is the most known of them all, Adrian. He's a challenger being very educative on stream and on YouTube. Alois is a very good Riven player with a unique playstyle. He doesn't stream that much nowadays though, but you can follow him on Twitter and ask him for tips. I'm sure he would enjoy helping you. You can also watch Boxbox. He's a very good Riven player and you can learn a lot from watching him. Don't hesitate to join the Riven main subreddit and to look up for whatever you need. Thank you guys for watching and I see you in the next video. I should post a lot on Twitter, so do not hesitate to follow me there if you want to. And if you want to follow me on Twitch, you can, even though I don't stream that much, and I tend to hint my ass off whenever I'm playing live. So anyway, I see you guys soon.